There, Patronet. I should like to run a sword with Pawn.
Let us do nothing rash, my boy, though he certainly is reputable villain.
Yes, Signor Silvio, Dr. Lombardi. I have news for you. Come on, come on.
Speak, what do you have to say?
Well, to cut a long story short, the man, whom we thought to be Signor Federigo, has turned out to be his sister, Beatrice.
What? I don't understand you.
Then you are very thick-headed. The man, whom we thought to be Signor Federigo, a male, turned out to be his sister, Beatrice, a female.
A woman.
A woman?
Dressed as a man?
Dressed as a man.
At last, I understand.
About time you did.
But how is it going to happen? Tell me.
Come along in and I'll explain all. Your father, too. If people let bygones be bygones.
We will, sir, and I must humbly beg your pardon for letting myself behave the way I did this morning.
Ah, think no more of it. I understand it. You must have fit. Come along in, come along in.
Will you all please leave me alone? I will have a pretty fuss.
Come, Clarice, pull yourself together. You see, Signor Silvio has repented and asks for your forgiveness. If he has acted foolishly, it is all for love of you. I have forgiven him for the way he spoke to me this morning. You are to forgive him, too.
Dear Clarice, I know I deserve to be punished, but punish me with your harsh words rather than your silence. Behold me at your feet. Pity me.
Did you hear that sigh? It's a good sign.
Those are the tears in my eyes, Clarice.
Bravo, well said.
Cruel.
Quick, then. Come up with you. Yes, stand up. Stand up, Angel. Put your hand out. There we go.
Now, be happy. No more tears. No more nonsense. And may heaven bless you both.
Poor Signora Beatrice, I'm happy things are troubled are all over.
Your most humble servant, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, are you the master of this house?
Why, yes, I am.
Well, it's my honor to finally meet you.
Well, I congratulate you most heartily upon your good fortune.
I come here by the command of Signora Beatrice.
That idiot servant of ours. Me, sir?
I don't know.
Oh, sir, do you remember what you promised me?
Promised you? Ah, yes, of course. Let me do my best here. Senor Pantanina, even though this is the first occasion that I finally come to meet you, I come with a bold desire to ask you.
I will serve you to the best of my powers.
My servant wants your man. Do you have any objection to this consent?
Well, for my part, I am agreed. And what say you, a woman servant?
If I thought he would make a good husband.
Is he a good, trustworthy man, that servant of yours?
For the short time that he has been with me, he seems to be trusty and intelligent.
Signor Corindo, you seem to have anticipated me in something that I ought to have done. I was asked to propose the marriage of my maid to Signor Beatrice. However, since you have asked for her for your servants, I can say no more.
Sir, madam, allow me to settle the matter. Signor Florindo, did you not ask for the hand of Smeraldina for your servant?
Why, yes, I just did that.
Oh, and you, Signor Ferice, do you not intend Signor Florindo's servant to have the hand of Signor Beatrice's?
That was my intention.
Then Smeraldina is mine. Give me your other hand. I can't live without both of them.
And what right have you to ask for her hand?
Oh, yes. Because I am both the servant of Signor Federigo and of Beatrice.
What? You rascal!
You knave!
You would unto the masters at once.
Yes, sir, I did. Yes, you know, they were hard indeed. But I can boast that no one would ever have found me out if I hadn't given myself away for the love of dear Smeraldina here. They haven't lasted long, it's true, but I can boast that I have done a very hard day's work, and my bread is very nasty, and I have done a very hard day's work, but in consideration of the whole fun of the thing, I hope that these ladies and gentlemen will come to forgive me.